Hola, buenas noches, ¿cómo están? Espero que todo esté bien con ustedes. Hoy es el lunes y eso significa que hoy tengo que continuar con mi desafío que estoy haciendo para mejorar mi oído en español. Y esta noche tengo que hacer un video muy rápido hablando sobre la canción que quiero estudiar esta semana. Y decidí que la canción que me gustaría estudiar es una canción de Sech. Él es de Panamá y la canción se llama Si te vas. Es una canción que me gusta, siempre estoy escuchándolo, pero la verdad es que nunca puedo entenderlo. Así que si de esta canción es una canción, parece que es una canción un poco triste, la verdad. Ozuna es en esta canción también. Pero sí, estoy muy emocionada para estudiarlo y aprender más vocabulario también.
Hello, hello, good evening. How are y'all doing? I'm just gonna be honest with you all. I was not planning on getting on here and making a video tonight because it's late and I'm tired and I've had a busy week. Busy, 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 busy week, and still squeezing in my Spanish too. But of course, you all know when I'm determined to finish these challenges, I never give up, regardless of the cost. But instead of not making a video tonight, I was so happy with my challenge today that I had to get on here and share with you all my progress for this week because, as you all know, this week I am studying. The song that I'm studying this week is Si Te Vas. It's a song by, what is his name? Sech y Ozuna también. Sech is from Panama y Ozuna is de Puerto Rico. And everyone knows that they are some extremely fast singers, and it's very difficult, especially with Ozuna. It's very difficult to understand everything because he cuts off his words tremendously when he's singing in his songs. But this week, when I started Monday, so the challenge for Monday was I had to listen to the song and write down what I thought they were saying, and I was like so off on everything because it wasn't right whenever I compared it to the actual lyrics. But for day two, we had to actually concentrate on the words that we did not know, utilize those words to practice them. And then today, we had to re-listen to the song again and compare our progress from Monday. And I just wanted to share with you all my progress, how far I came from Monday to today.
So this is from, and I'm sorry, my days are mixed up. Tuesday. This is Tuesday. This is from when I had to listen to the song and write down what I thought that they were saying in their lyrics. Lots of yellow. The yellow are words that were extremely off and wrong. It's like the whole page, front and back. So yeah, I was off a lot. Look, y'all, I was talking about on this part de Jesús. La recuerdas? He wasn't saying nothing about Jesus in this song. I was making up my own lyrics. It's so funny. If you all haven't tried this, I highly recommend you all to do it. It's quite entertaining, and like I said, it's a wonderful way to learn new vocabulary too. Especially when you compare your lyrics to what they really are saying. It's a good way to make that vocabulary stick. But I was so off. So on Wednesday, we actually had to write the correct lyrics. And then, where, let's see if I can. Okay, I had to find it. So, Wednesday, we actually had to write the correct lyrics. And usually, when I do that, I just find the song on YouTube with the lyrics. And as I listen to it, I write what the lyrics are saying on YouTube. And we had to go back, highlight the words we did not know. Which I had one, two, three, four, five. I think I had like 10 words that I wasn't for sure of. And then we had to turn around, take those words. Here's my 10 words. And then we had to write a paragraph utilizing all the words that we learned from the song. So that was our exercise for Wednesday. And then today we had to turn around and rewrite the lyrics. Otra vez, we had to write the lyrics again. Okay, and so today we actually had to re-listen to the song again for our third time. and write down what we thought they were saying and compare it to Monday, or compare it to Tuesday, which was our first attempt. And as you can see, not a lot of yellow, not a lot of errors. And the errors that I did make, it was like very small errors. La como veo, la cama ver. I don't think he said that. I think he said something else. The little small errors. So when you compare Tuesday, when I had no idea what they were saying whatsoever, to today, in just a short amount of time, look how much my listening has progressed with this song. So it's very, very useful, this exercise, this this challenge for this month to better your listening skills. I highly recommend it.
Estaba lleno de esperanza, pero la vida y el tiempo avanza. El que ama de verdad después de luchar se cansa. Yo estaba dispuesto, pero tú y la venganza querían arruinarme y mi corazón no aguanta.
So yeah, this week was extremely challenging for me because Ozuna, oh my gosh, he cuts off so many words in his songs. And but that's typical for, you know, the Caribbeans, like Puerto Rico, República Dominicana, Cuba, places like that. They cut off their words, and he is notorious for doing that in all of his songs. So it's definitely a challenge listening to his music and trying to decipher what he's saying. I've had quite a few people in the past who are like, you know what, if you're going to learn Spanish, don't listen to him. But at the same time, I kind of challenge that idea, because the thing is, when you meet people out in the streets, when you meet people in the stores, they're not going to be talking to you in proper Spanish. They're not going to be saying, like, it's similar to English. Like, when we meet people, we don't say, hi, how are you doing? You know, it's like, that's Duolingo. We don't talk like that. You know, we're like, hey, how you doing? You know, it's real short, real simple. We cut off a lot of our words too. So that's why when I'm practicing, I don't mind listening and practicing with like Ozuna, Nicky Jam. Yes, it's challenging, but at the same time, I really want to train my ears the way that people would normally typically speak if I was to meet them out in public. So don't be afraid, like whenever you are studying your songs, studying your lyrics, don't be afraid to go off the limb and challenge yourself and get like a difficult song, get a fast song. Another plus with that is if you practice with fast songs, next time you listen to something slower, it's not going to sound as fast because your ears are accustomed to listening to faster music or faster language. So it's something that I recommend you to do when you are practicing with lyrics. But yes, that's my video for tonight. Just wanted to share that with you all, because like I said, I was very happy whenever I checked for my ears and it wasn't a lot of yellow, and I just had to hop on here and make a quick video about it. But yes, I hope that you all have a good night. Y hasta luego.